Sound design.
So what is virtual time shift and how do you use it in SATlive? Well, in the last videos, we've been looking at how to take a look at our main sub alignment and use things like delay suggestion tool, live add trace, and perfect addition trace to just give us more information and let us know how we're doing. So in the last video, we used delay suggestion tool to give us some suggestions as to what we could do to our main speaker in terms of delay and polarity inversion to get a better alignment with our sub. And it took a little bit of time because we had to test each one and then see what the results were. You can speed this process up even more with virtual time shift. So here's where we left off in a previous video. And if I click on this plus symbol and then virtual time shift, then this will give me the ability to virtually adjust the phase of my live trace. So look at this blue trace down here. This is my live main trace. And if I add delay, it's going to start bending down. Okay? And if I add a polarity inversion, it's going to flip 180 degrees. Okay, so let's look at our delay suggestion tool again and see how we can quickly test the suggestions from the tool. Suggest delay. And you remember, we had two options we wanted to try. 2.7 milliseconds and then 7.6 with a polarity inversion. So let's try 2.7 first. So with 2.7 milliseconds of the delay on our main trace, this live blue trace, you can see, looks like we're pretty perfect already. Our yellow live addition trace is right on top of our perfect addition trace. So that should be good enough. And down here, looking at the phase, it looks like that's really close. But this says, hey, you could even do better with 7.6. And I'm thinking, I'd love to do better. Let's try it. So we'll move up to 7.6. And which is closer, 7.75. Let's try 7.5. Polarity inversion. Now, it does look closer a little bit, maybe, in here. But to me, here, the effects on the live add trace are negligible. Now it's right on top of the pink one, but I don't think we got so much more improvement that I would really want to take this added delay and the complexity of a polarity inversion that I have to think about. So I'm probably going to stick with the original suggestion of 2.7 milliseconds. So now I would make sure to cancel this and I would put those changes. Into the outputs, and then I would do my measurement and verify that I was actually getting that summation that SATlive predicted. So that's how you can use virtual time shift in SATlive to quickly test some of these ideas and see which is going to work the best.